You loved her as Jill Taylor on the hit 90s sitcom Home Improvement. Now she's starring in a new dark comedy called Cubby alongside her other guest. Welcome, Patricia Richardson and Mark Blane. Hi, guys.
Hi.
So good to see you. Okay, real quick, I'm sure you get this question all the time. A Home Improvement reboot was in the works, right?
No.
No?
It was never in the works.
It really wasn't.
No, it was never in the works.
Okay.
I read something on Twitter. Tim said something about, oh, yeah, well, you know, I'm thinking about it. And I've talked to people. He never talked to me.
Really?
Yeah. He never talked to Jonathan. He never talked to, I think, Taryn. So I don't know who he talked to,
Patricia,
but he didn't talk to
know.
Us.
We are going to do a reboot. It's a prequel, and I'm playing Tim, a young Tim. And yeah, Patricia's playing young Jill.
Young Jill. Okay, I think that's awesome.
So that's a stretch.
We'll just start.
We got it.
All right, Tim.
Not happening. And you know, that's why they have Last Man Standing.
Okay, yes.
You know, so.
Exactly. Well, that's true. Exactly. That's when Last Man Standing may have gone off the air, but yes.
No.
So, okay, Cubby is the movie that you guys have developed together, but I heard that there
was some... No, he did it. I just came in. They'd already shot the movie. I came in. They decided to add some footage.
Mm-hmm.
And I was part of the added... footage.
I wrote the movie and my mom was in it, the mom character, but she was never seen.
Okay.
And then a year later, I wanted to insert these scenes that I thought would bring the story up. My character was going to be much more developed by seeing where he came from.
It's so well done, by the way. I heard that there was some drama behind the scenes. Is there anything that you want to...
Do you mean the Kodak problem?
I think that's what I mean.
Okay, all the added stuff.
So first of all, my co-director,
you guys
Ben,
are good, mother, son.
No, yeah. You have to let me say this, because
I'm so
mad on his behalf. Here he is, he's a first-time director, a first-time writer, and it's the first time acting, right? And you got money from IFP, is that what it's called?
Yeah, we were supported by many organizations, including mm-hmm. IFP, the Independent mm-hmm. Filmmaker Project.
Yeah, because they believed in you. And Susan Sontag was your mentor, is that right? Didn't you have a mentor or something?
Susan Stover. Susan A. Stover.
Stupid. Okay, so he does it. So we're shooting all this extra stuff. He rewrote, he put added stuff, me and some other stuff. So he shot this film on 16mm, which is a pretty brave thing to do for your first film, right? Kodak gave him damaged film.
Oh, no.
They admitted.
Did you have to cut stuff?
Everything I shot was on damaged film. Everything we shot extra week.
We got professionals around the world to fix it frame by frame.
Okay. And which is expensive.
It's very expensive.
But Kodak wouldn't do a thing.
The movie was saved. To start in a positive place, the movie was inspired by. The movie was inspired by 1970s rom-coms and 90s kids' movies.
Mark.
We wanted that nostalgic mix with 16mm.
Can I just interrupt you really quick? If we don't get to the clip, I won't get to it. I just want to make sure.
Yes.
Yeah, let me go.
So I want to see
you
it.
It's really good. And this is undamaged film from Cubby.
Okay.
Look.
Are you the happiest boy in the world? I'm the happiest mom. Oh, Mark, don't be a sourpuss.
A gallery receptionist is an entry-level job, Peg. I'm going to sit behind a desk and ask people to sign... Let's sign the
guest book.
I can't talk to people.
Mark, you are somewhat unbearable, but all the unbearable people move here. You're gonna kill it. You're gonna make it work. Get a raise, take on the world.
Good pep talk.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm so glad you fixed that scene because it was so worth it. And I think that's why everybody should get behind your film, because you had all of these challenges.
I spent 7 years on it. My producer, Carolina Jimenez, and my co-director, Ben Mankoff, we had so much passion. And because Patricia believed in us and because so many people believed
does.
In us, we finished the film.
Sure.
And it was it's an indie gritty film, and you don't have to be a rich kid from, a really privileged place to make a film. You can do it through passion.
Good.
And
nice.
I didn't even get to the psychedelic cupcake part, but Cubby makes its world, the leather superhero or the psychedelic cupcake part, it makes its world premiere at Outfest, the LGBTQ film festival here in LA this weekend. The movie will have two screenings at the TCL Chinese Six Theaters, one this Friday at 7:30, the other Sunday at 11. For tickets, go to www.outfest.org, and we're rooting for you. So
thank you.
Congratulations.
Mom and Dad, hi. I love you.
Other mom.
Other mom.
Other mom.
Other mom.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you guys.
Thanks so much for having me.